In this Cricut tutorial, I am using the brand new Cricut Mug Press to do a side-by-side comparison between the Cricut Infusible Ink Mugs compared to the white Sublimation Mugs from Amazon, just to see which one performs better. So let's get crafty. Hey, I'm Michael from the Mr. Crafty Pants YouTube channel, where I show you the best ways to use your Cricut cutting machine every single week. But today I'm over here on the Design Bundles YouTube channel because we have partnered up to bring you all another Cricut tutorial. So be sure that you stay tuned until the very end of today's episode because y'all do not want to miss out on a single Cricut minute. Now, unless y'all have been living under a rock over the last few weeks or so, then you probably know that Cricut has released their brand new Cricut Mug Press. And let me just say this for starters, at first I was just a little skeptical about the whole thing, but I've since come to actually like it. But one of the questions I see most often in my group, as well as plenty of other Facebook groups, is can you use other types of mugs inside of the Cricut Mug Press instead of just the regular Cricut Infusible Ink mugs? And the answer to that is absolutely 100% yes. However, which one is actually going to perform better? Is it going to be the actual Cricut brand Infusible Ink, or is it going to be the white Sublimation Mug from Amazon? So we are going to do a blind side-by-side test and let you all decide which one you all think is better. Now, to make all this magic happen, we obviously need the mugs, we obviously need the mug press, but we're also going to need a cutting machine. Now, I'm using my Cricut Maker just because it is already sitting out here on the desk. That is it. I could just as easily use my Cricut Joy, my Cricut Explore, or really any type of cutting machine as long as that cutting machine works with SVG cut files. Also, to go along with all of this, we're going to need some Cricut Infusible Ink. Now, I said that we're going to need the Infusible Ink. That's not necessarily true. You can actually do sublimation with the Cricut Mug Press as well, although some of that is a little testy. People are testing to see what it's going to come out best with the sublimation so far. But we, as for today, we are using the Infusible Ink and we're using this pattern right here. We are actually using this camo pattern, which will hopefully make a little bit more sense once you see our SVG cut file. And speaking of our SVG cut file, let's head over now to designbundles.net and I'll show you which one I'm using. All right, so here is our SVG cut file, this Adventures Fueled by Coffee. And let me just say that as soon as I saw this SVG cut file, I knew that this would look perfect on a mug with this camo infusible ink. I just love it. I think it's gonna look super, super cool. Now, currently at the time of filming this, it is marked down from $4 to $2. So it is currently half off. However, by the time that you watch this video, it could be a different price. You never know, but if you see it, even for $4, that's a great price, but especially if you see it for anywhere around this $2 mark, that is an especially great price. So go ahead and grab that. But now let's just go ahead and head over to Cricut Design Space and we'll get started putting all this together. And as you can see here, I already had this file downloaded from designbundles.net and uploaded into Cricut Design Space. But the first thing I want you to take a look at is right over here on the right-hand side of the page in the layers panel. So as you can see, this one SVG cut file has tons of layers to it and we don't need all of that. So while all this is selected, what I'm gonna do is come down here towards the bottom right-hand side of the page and click on Weld. And Weld basically just fuses all those into one single solid layer. But there was one small little issue that happened. So let's take a look right over here. You can see that all of a sudden this U in Fueled has disappeared. So the good thing is we literally just welded it together. So all we have to do is basically undo it. We can still undo it. So let's come up here towards the top left-hand side of the page, click this little back arrow like so. And then all of a sudden our U is back in place. So to actually fix this, what I'm gonna do is come over here to the right-hand side of the page, and I'm actually gonna come up here and ungroup all of this first, just like so. And then I'm gonna go through here and select that U right there. And what I'm gonna do is actually right-click it and then select Send to Back. And now I'm gonna click and drag over all this yet again. And then we're gonna come back down here towards the bottom right-hand side of the page and click on Weld. Just like that. And we have welded it into one single solid layer and it's still here with us. So typically this little tip or trick or hack or whatever you want to call it, typically it will work if you send it all the way to the back or bring it all the way to the front. If one of them doesn't work, just undo it and try it again. by doing the opposite direction, essentially. All right, so what I'm gonna do now is come over here to the left-hand side of the page. I'm gonna click on images, and I am just simply gonna do a search for mug template. And so I'm simply gonna select that, and then come down here towards the bottom right-hand side of the page and click on insert images. All right, so here is our template. Now, here's the thing, y'all. We do not want to resize this template at all. Do not even touch that resize handle because this is already sized perfectly for our mugs. So what I'm actually gonna do is essentially click on our design here because this design is way too big for this template. I'm gonna click on this design and then come down here towards the bottom right-hand side of this design, click on this little resize handle and then just drag it inwards just like so. Now here's the thing though, our design is actually behind our template. So all I have to do is right click this and then select send to front. And then just like so, I can bring this right over top of this circle. Now I'm really liking how our design is positioned and sized over top of the circle. So what I'm actually gonna do is slice our design out of the circle itself. Now before we even do that, what I'm gonna do is right click it and then select duplicate and then just move this little spare copy off to the side. And then by actually selecting our design, the one that's over top of our purple circle here, I'm gonna hold down the shift key and then come over here to the right-hand side of the page and click this layer that has the purple circles. And I'm basically gonna slice those out. Now, here's the thing with slice, it will only work if two layers are selected. That's it, two layers. It won't work if you have one layer selected and it will not work if you have three or more layers selected. So as you can see over here in this layers panel, this layer is selected and this purple layer is selected right here. So since those two are now selected, this little slice option right here is suddenly available. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on slice. And just like that, here is our design that is now sliced out of our purple circle here. So this is what we actually sliced out. So I'm actually gonna delete that out. And now I'm going to click this little slice result, bring this off to the side. This is basically garbage now too. And as you can see, it sliced our design out of the background that we're using for this. So what I'm now gonna do is repeat that exact same process, but over here on the other side. I'm gonna right click it and then select send to front. And again, just get this positioned where I need it to be. All right, so yet again, remember that we can only do two layers for slicing. So one layer is selected and that is the layer right here with the purple. So I'm basically gonna hold down my shift key and make sure that both of these are selected. And then I'm now gonna come down here towards the bottom right hand side of the page and click on slice. So now I can actually move my design out of the way and delete that out. This little remnant of that design, we can delete that out as well. And then all this right here, this is just the remnants of what we sliced. So that can all be deleted as well. And there we go. Now there is one more thing that I'm wanting to do with the design itself, and that is to actually duplicate it, but it may not be for the reason that you think it is for. So basically I'm gonna right click this and then select duplicate. And I am now going to take this little template and then come down here towards the bottom right hand side of the page and click on contour. Now contour is just a really, really great tool that you can actually go in here and just customize out an image even more so by actually just removing different parts of it. So what I'm gonna do is come over here to the bottom right hand side of this hide contour box and then select hide all contours. And whenever you do that, basically what Cricut Design Space is gonna do is remove everything in that image except for whatever the largest part or the largest element of that image is, which in this case will actually be the outline of our design. And that is very purposeful, the reason that we're doing this, which will hopefully make a little bit more sense here shortly. So now I'm just gonna click outside of this little hide contour box. And here is just the outline of our template. So what I'm gonna do is click and drag over both of these layers. And I wanna come up here towards the top of the canvas and then select align and then select center. And I'm actually going to click on just the top layer, this purple layer like so, and then select send it back. And then again, just click and drag over both of these layers. And this time I wanna come down here towards the bottom right-hand side of the page and click on attach. Now, hopefully this will all make a little bit more sense. The reason why we did this is because I personally want the outline of our template to be completely removed from the rest of the sheet of the Infusible Ink transfer sheet. And so to do that, by actually just taking the outline of the template itself, duplicating that and then attaching it, not welding it, not doing anything else, but attaching it to the other lines. It's basically sending a command to our Cricut cutting machine to cut that area out twice. So that's exactly what we did. This is a little tip or trick or hack for you. And to me personally, I feel like this works just really, really great. I love it. Now what we're gonna do is actually duplicate this because, well, we are doing one for our Cricut Infusible Ink mug, and then we're doing the other for the Sublimation mug from Amazon. So let's come up here towards the top right-hand side of the page and click on Make It. And let's make sure that there's a little bit of space between both of these designs. So basically on this matte preview screen, it's showing you where at on the cutting mats the design will be cut out at. So I'm basically just gonna scoot this down just a pinch, just to give it a little bit of breathing room. And the other thing I'm gonna do is make sure that these designs are mirrored. So with the Infusible Ink transfer sheets, it is very important to mirror your designs. And to do that, all we have to do is come over here to the left-hand side of the page and click on Mirror. Just that simple. So now let's come down here towards the bottom right-hand side of the page and click on Continue. Now here on the base material cut settings page, this is basically where we tell our cutting machine what material we're going to be cutting out. Now the Cricut Explore device does not have an Infusible Ink transfer sheet setting. So what you want to do is actually turn your knob over to custom, and then you'll have all these same options. So what I want to do is select Infusible Ink transfer sheet. And if you don't see it on this page for you, just come over here to where it says browse all materials, and then just do a search for Infusible. Just like that. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and load the Infusible Ink onto my cutting mat. But before we even come close to touching the Infusible Ink, you want to make sure that your hands are very clean. You wanna make sure that you wash them and thoroughly, thoroughly dry them before you actually touch the transfer sheet. You wanna make sure that there's no lotion on your hands or excessive oil or anything of the sort. Now, personally, I like to play it safe and then just put on some rubber gloves because, well, it's never failed me yet. And I really wanna make sure that I don't ruin these transfer sheets because, well, they're not the cheapest thing ever. I'm just saying. All right, so another thing with the transfer sheets is that you always want to make sure that the pattern is facing up towards you. And we'll go ahead and load this into our cutting machine. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and unload my mat. And per usual, what I always like to do is slip my mat over and then peel the mat away from my material instead of the other way around. However, since we are working with Infusible Ink, make sure that your countertop or your table that you're working on is really clean because, again, you don't want anything to actually get on or adhere to this ink. All right, so before we even start weeding all of that out, what I wanna do is actually preheat my Cricut mug press, get this all warmed up and ready. So whenever we're done weeding out all the Infusible Ink, we're ready to go with the actual mug press as well. Now, this is super, super simple. All you have to do is press the one button on the machine and that's it. So there is literally just one single solid button. And just by simply turning that on, it'll start preheating. So super simple. Now they do recommend to have this in a well-ventilated area, and they also recommend to actually have this set up on a heat-resistant area as well. So to actually accommodate for the heat-resistant area, I'm actually just gonna sit this right over here on top of my Cricut Easy Press mat. There we go. So I'm gonna go ahead and just move this out of the way. That way we can start weeding out our designs right here. Now, as you can see, our little trick about actually duplicating the template, or at least the outline of the template and attaching it, worked really, really well for making sure that this separated from the rest of the Infusible Ink transfer sheet. So I love that. Now it comes time to actually weed it all out. Now, with the Infusible Ink transfer sheets, I'm not saying that you can't use a weeding tool like a pin or anything of the sort. However, to me, it is easier to actually just weed it out by hand because this is a very different type of material, especially if you've never used this before. It's a unique material, let's just call it that. Now, whenever it comes time to actually weeding, it makes it a whole lot easier if you actually start to roll the actual transfer sheet and do what they call cracking. So basically you'll hear the different pieces of the Infusible Ink cracking apart and separating, which is a really cool kind of effect, but it's basically just separating itself, which makes it so much easier to weed. All right, so now I'm just gonna simply dive in with actually weeding it out. All All right, so we are completely done weeding, and we did lose some of the really, really, really small little bits and bobs along the way, but ultimately, I don't think you'll even be able to notice. So what I'm gonna do now is go ahead and apply these to our mugs. Now, actually, one small thing that I forgot to mention was actually wiping down the surface of the mug. Now, some people will actually use a lint roller to make sure you get all the lint or dirt or dust off of the cup. Me personally, I like to use some rubbing alcohol and a lint-free shop towel. All right, so now we can actually apply the infusible ink. Now, whenever applying this, I really do like to make sure I kind of have a bird's eye view with all this, just to make sure that it is lined up appropriately. All right, so that's not right. So let me actually pull this off and recenter it a little bit. All right, so now that I have an overall idea of where I want this to go on the actual cup, I'm gonna basically just kind of maneuver this a little bit to make sure that it is all lined up exactly the way we want. You also really want to make sure that this is pulled very, very taut onto the cup. And again, you want to make sure that this is pulled as tight as possible and that all of the areas around the infusible ink is as adhered down to the cup as good as possible as well. All right, so our mug press is completely preheated. So what we're gonna do now is go ahead and grab one of our mugs and then very, very carefully place it inside of the mug press. All right, so I also wanna make sure I take a really quick little peek in there, making sure that all of our infusible ink is actually being covered by the heat press around it. And once that it is, all we're gonna do is press down on this little clamp right here. Now you will notice that there are 5 little dots up here at the top of the mug press. And basically once all 5 lights are completely lit up, the mug will be finished. Now, there are no settings with this, which did throw me for a little bit of a loop whenever I was first playing around with this. But what they say is that the mug press itself takes into account the temperature of the room, as well as the temperature of the mug itself. And basically based on that, it calculates how much heat and how much time to actually apply the infusible ink transfer sheets for. Also, another thing to keep in mind is that the best type of mug to put in here is the type of mug that has the flat wall like so. Basically, any type of mug that has a curve to it is not going to do very well inside of this particular mug press. All right, so this is all finished. So what we're going to do now is actually pull up on this little lever. And then just very, very carefully grab the handle. Now, since the handle actually sticks out from the mug press, you don't really have to worry about this getting too hot. Like this right now, I don't feel any heat on the handle, period. So we're just gonna set this off to the side on a heat resistant area, and we're gonna go ahead and load in the next mug. Again, make sure that all of your design is covered, and then go ahead and push down on the lever. All right, so this one is all done now too. So I'm gonna go ahead and lift up the lever and then very, very carefully remove the mug. All right, so now I'm just gonna let those cool off completely, completely to the touch before I even attempt to remove the infusible ink transfer sheets. All right, so I am gonna go ahead and remove the infusible ink transfer sheet from the first mug. And now I'm about to remove the infusible ink transfer sheet from the second mug. All right, so just a few key takeaways with all of this. The first one being, if you are using a third-party sublimation mug versus a Cricut infusible ink mug, you do want to make sure that your mug is between 11 ounces and 15 ounces, and that it also has flat walls or flat sides to it as well. I would also love to know which one you all thought turned out better, the Cricut infusible ink mug or the one from Amazon, or could you even tell a difference at all? Let us know down in that comment section below. And also, while you're at it, just take an extra second to stamp that like button. And if you're new around here to the Design Bundles YouTube channel, well, then you may want to consider stamping that subscribe button and ringing that little bell for all the notifications, because they put out new crafty content, no joking, just about every single day. And y'all do not want to miss out on a single crafty minute. Thank you all so, so, so much for watching today's episode. It truly does mean the absolute world to us. And until next time, stay crafty.